Hey everyone, Daniel from Twin Bytes with another tech-torial for you, this time about online backup versus online storage. There's been so much confusion about this topic, and people have lost their data because of the ignorance about it. So in this video, I'm going to explain the differences and what they are with some examples, so that way you can be sure that your data is safe as expected. Stick around. Okay, so as promised, we're going to talk about the difference between the cloud backup versus the cloud storage. So first off, looking at some of the confusion on this is what's the same. So your data is actually stored in the cloud online on the internet. So both of them will do that. And your data is safe from computer crashes or if the computer is lost or stolen. So whether you're using the online storage or the online backup, if your computer gets dropped, broken, stolen, anything happens to it, crash, you will still be able to retrieve your data. Just get a new computer or have it rebuilt, and then you can go online and download all your information again, either from the online backup or just sync it on from the cloud storage. And the other thing is that your data is also accessible from any device, so both of them will do that as well. But the difference is that with the online backup, it's not usable directly online the same way as the online storage. So I'll explain more of that in a moment. So what's the big difference is that with the cloud backup, your data is safe from any kind of accidental deletion, corruption. If you get a hacker or you get a virus infection, your data will still be safe because it's a backup copy. It's not being synchronized. The cloud drives are vulnerable because it's synchronizing the data. So if you accidentally delete something, it synchronizes that deletion to the cloud drive. But if it's a cloud backup, it's not going to delete it from your backup. And it is a second copy of the data, not a synced copy. So that's why it will help you with the online backup. And the cloud backups or online backup, I use the term interchangeably, online backup or cloud backup, it's the same thing. They're scheduled to backup at set intervals where a cloud drive is set to synchronize automatically and immediately as soon as anything is changed, edit, deleted, or added. So how it works, basically looking at some of the examples here, is on the left side of the screen we've got the online drives such as Dropbox, Google Drive, OneDrive, or iCloud. All your data is stored on the cloud, but it synchronizes a copy to your computer. So as I mentioned before, if your computer dies or it's lost or stolen, that's fine. Get a new computer, synchronize your drives, all your data is there. But if you had a virus or you deleted something or you had a hacker go and encrypt all your data on you, it synchronizes that deletion or virus or corruption or encryption up to the cloud storage. So then you would lose all of that data in the cloud as well. So even if you went out and got another computer, as soon as you go to synchronize that, you'll see that your data is still missing or corrupted or encrypted. So it's not going to help you from a lot of those disasters. But on the right side of the screen, we've got services for online backups that are like Data Deposit Box, Carbonite, or even the Avast Cloud Care Backup, which I offer. Those are a one-way backup, so it only backs up in one direction, and that's to the cloud. It doesn't sync back. So if you deleted something by accident, before you back up again, you can go online and retrieve what you had. Or especially if you had a virus or corruption to a file, or if you had your files encrypted, which happens to a lot of people, then you would have a copy online, and you'll have plenty of time to sign into your backup account and recover your files again. But you know, that versus the cloud drive, it would have synchronized those changes right away. So you really need to have an online backup, and if you are expecting to use something like OneDrive or Google Drive or any of those as a backup source, it is synchronizing the files to your computer, so it's not a true backup. One of the myths about this that I've heard so many times is people trying to free up space on their computer because they're running out of storage, so they'll upload their files to one of those cloud drives. But what they don't realize is it synchronizes the files. It's not storing it only online. You do have the option of not synchronizing it and upload it to the cloud and keep it only in the cloud, but you know, it's only in one place, and if it's lost, stolen, or deleted or corrupted, you don't have a copy of it and it's online, so you have to have an internet connection for it. But that would free up space if you did it that way. But by default, the way the cloud drives work is they synchronize a copy to your computer for your convenience and speed, so it's not freeing up space on the computer. So to summarize this, you always want to use some kind of a backup, whether it's an online backup like I mentioned in the previous slide, or a local backup that you use with a USB drive. You always have to back up your data because something will go wrong at some point in time and you're going to need to recover your data. So you got to be covered somehow. The cloud storage is an optional thing, so don't use it thinking it's a backup or that it's going to free up space on your computer. The purpose of the online storage is for the convenience of central storage, having that among multiple devices if you use more than one, or if it's for work and you're sharing it with other people collaborating. And the cloud storage is also good for fault tolerance, such as if you had a computer crash or something like that. So that will give you, it's not a backup, but it's fault tolerance. Maybe if you guys want, I can make a video discussing more about fault tolerance. So let me know in the comments below what you think about that. So that's it for this tech-torial. I hope you guys found this video helpful, and if you have any questions or want to find out anything else on even other topics, please let me know in the comments below. Give this video a thumbs up if you found it helpful, and subscribe if you haven't already. I put out videos every week, and I wouldn't be doing these if it wasn't for you guys. So thanks so much for watching and sticking around to the end, if you're still here, and we will see you in the next video. Bye for now.